RiffTrax. We don't make movies, we make fun of them. And now, the Riff Master himself, Michael J. Nelson.
Thank you, and welcome once again to RiffTrax, where I am joined by Bill Corbett and Kevin Murphy.
Thank you, Mike. And may I say how happy I am that our movie, Twilight, is finally telling the world something I've been saying for years, that vampires are sparkly. Oh, the world laughed at me and my quote-unquote crazy ideas about vampire sparkliness, but maybe now that the truth is out, I'll get an apology. Kevin.
I never denied their sparkliness, Bill. We just happen to disagree very, very strongly about whether that sparkliness is a full-bodied sparkliness, huh? Is it sparkly between their toes? Sparkly on the bottom of their feet? Their inner thighs sparkly? These are important questions, and I don't think Twilight has settled them.
Oh, you had to bring up the sparkly thigh thing, didn't you? When you know that it all hinges on the butt cheeks. Frankly, sir, your views on this are well outside the norm in the vampire sparkliness research community.
How dare you, sir?
I dare.
My contributions to the vampire butt cheek sparkliness research are renowned, and I'll not have your slander. Shame on you, sir.
No shame on you.
No shame on...
Okay. Why don't we just pass it off to Disembodio, who, when he's just been wiped down with Windex, is very sparkly indeed.
Thank you, Mike. If you play your cards right, you can find out just how far that sparkliness goes. Yeah, anyway, I will be here to help keep this RiffTrax synced up to your Twilight DVD. Every so often, I'll chime in with a line of dialogue at the exact same moment that a character says it. That way, you'll be able to tell if you're all synced up to the DVD, and if not, you can pause either the RiffTrax or the movie for the appropriate amount of time, usually just a second or less.
All right, let's get started. In a moment, I'll ask you to pause this track, put in your Twilight DVD, and press play. You'll soon see the logo for Summit Entertainment. The moment that fades completely to black, press play again on this track, and you should be all set. Okay, get ready to pause this RiffTrax. 1, 2, 3, pause. And we are back. Sparkly vampires, everyone. We join this reading of Fiona Apple's diary, already in progress.
Bambi meets Godzilla, the live-action remake.
The Numa Numa guy?
Seems like a good way to go.
Another good way to go? Getting sat on by a hippo.
Oh yeah, top-notch.
We interrupt our melodramatic narration to bring you this venison.
Ironically, this deer was just thinking about how it wanted to die. It wants to be plowed over by a forerunner driven by someone on their cell phone.
So natural causes, then.
For a deer, yeah.
More deer hunting than the deer hunter.
The acts that followed were swift and unspeakable.
Wish I'd brought more than a cactus, though.
Words uttered for the first time in history.
And, well, that's pretty much all Phoenix has.
I would miss seeing her act that way when I hit her pills.
Vin Diesel ain't gonna impersonate himself.
Like Hot Topic.
But what do I know? I'm just your typically abnormally confident, world-weary 16-year-old female protagonist. Tee-hee.
Goodbye, Grand Canyon. Goodbye, Saguaro National Park. Goodbye, needlessly confusing decision not to observe daylight savings time.
Summit Entertainment presents an inexplicable cultural phenomenon.
Twilight, coldly calculated to pander to your shrieking demographic.
Under a near constant cover of clouds and rain.
The Forkers.
Ah, so it's not just one of the more notable towns he passed through?
His unfortunate catchphrase is, "Nobody forks with the chief of police."
Yeah.
Also, sorry for forgetting your last 9 birthdays.
I meant from when I picked you up at the airport. Technically, it's true.
It's been a tense car ride ever since she told him that his mustache made him look like a failed pervert.
Failed.
Exactly.
I stopped coming when a group of local farmers decided that I was to blame for their bad harvests and burnt me in effigy.
A bank robbery claimed three lives while Bella's dad used the town's only police car to pick her up.
I've divided it down the middle. Do you want the shower side or the toilet side?
It's a Bjergen!
Oh, thank God, because I bought a lot of Purplesaurus Rex Kool-Aid. A lot.
I'm just gonna stand here and hold this cactus for a while.
He's crooked.
If you're gonna need to use your half of the bathroom, you may want to do it now.
Another one of the best things about Charlie, he can change his shirt and go outside really quickly.
A random overtaking at camp that time?
Well, I'm glad you're finally here.
Mostly about how much free time he'll have while you're doing all the housework.
Son, you stay here and leer at the girl.
I regret that part of my life.
They make out a lot more.
Cost me a whole string of beads.
Ow! First the disease blankets and now this!
But not the bomb diggity, no okay?
Way. All 16-year-old girls have a natural ability to drive an unsynced manual transmission.
Plus, it's Saturday, you know, don't really want to go.
I guess you could say I'm having reservations myself.
We got running water last month while our sacred tribal lands were turned into a Motel 6.
Just got warm enough to lean against cars in the parking lot before class.
Yep, as the new girl, she'll fit right in by driving Fred Sanford's truck.
She's lost already. Damn you, disproportionately huge high school for a town of 3,000!
I'm the principal.
Tentacle hentai.
Like Linda from Sesame Street.
At least let me kill a guy first or something.
Something that Woodward and Bernstein were saying all the time.
Yeah, this looks like volleyball, but without shirtless men flexing and Kenny Loggins' music, it's difficult to tell.
Oh, my retina detached!
Every time I play, dorks end up getting hurt.
Isabella makes me sound fat.
Are you from the town of Joaquin Phoenix?
Or because I smuggled endangered reptile eggs across state lines.
Her fidgetiness is quick to win over her peers.
Who the hell was he offering the burrito to?
Ha ha ha, our surprisingly diverse group of friends certainly does have fun.
Or the pale and appealing nervous toy.
Whoa, someone needs to chillax.
I thought he proposed the feature and agreed not to do it 10 seconds later.
Toad licking.
It'd be great for our annual genital scandals issue.
High school girls discussing wang sizes. We have officially hit rock bottom, gentlemen.
Shh, I'm trying to hear about the wang sizes.
Ah, say no more. Wait, say more.
After a tragic accident at a pancake makeup factory?
Hello, doing your sister.
They're like a thing.
Fortunately, small-town America has great tolerance for such deviant behavior.
I am in pain. My Speedo stuffing went horribly, horribly awry.
The glasses might be a problem.
Ladies?
No, you're just not related enough for him.
Oh, and also, they're vampires. I always leave that out.
Usually a pale, creepy guy staring at you from across a dining room just means you're eating at Denny's.
The grim look of a man whose lumberjack slam arrived cold.
Welcome to remedial creationism.
All the teenage girls swoon at the sight of Edward throwing up a little in his mouth.
The stuffed armadillo is vital. Without it, none of these kids would be able to learn a damn thing about science.
It's the key.
Watery, full of flatworms. They gave these kids Bud American Ale.
Hey-o. Chitlins and skull tobacco. That would explain it.
That look is from the guy you alert the flight attendant about collection.
You don't know a damn thing about planaria, do you? Do you?
Oh, God, I shouldn't have drank that sample. Whoa. Yeah.
Okay, for homework, I want you to write a story about a young planaria that dreams of joining the circus.
Also, you can change subjects 3/4 through the school year.
Oh, see you in science tomorrow, Bella.
Well, this overshadows all the other guys fawning over me and the girls going out of their way to include me.
No kidding. On my first day of high school, the wrestling team made me eat part of a gym mat and the girls nicknamed me Diaper Guy.
Eating here regularly should take care of that.
Had a bit part in a Seinfeld episode.
Butt Crack Santa sounds like the sidekick on a wacky morning radio show.
With real Frankenberries.
This is the kindest she's ever been treated in her 17 years as a diner waitress. She could be heard weeping from the bathroom.
Thank you.
Don't think the squeeze ketchup bottle requires vigorous shaking there, honey.
Oh, God! I don't want to even know what happens if it goes poorly.
Maybe you should try holding your cell in a quirky manner.
Where the hell are they?
The spring training garage? What?
Well, everyone except the vampires.
Dad made me pay for dinner.
Good luck tracking down one of those extremely rare cell phone chargers.
Yeah,
that look from the guy in car peeping in on yoga class through binoculars collection.
I ride to school in this unconventional fashion because of my crippling hemorrhoids.
So I got over the relatively minor incident, moved on with my damn life.
Come liven up our discussion with your bubbly personality.
Can't socialize, obsessed with crappy book series.
Brilliant lyrics on the soundtrack here.
So I figured he was sick and stopped taking it personally.
The cafeteria served spaghetti on pizza day, but then it turned out it was just a misprint and they did in fact have pizza.
Time to make the donuts, dear God! It's time to make the donuts!
You can tell they're vampires because they jump like that.
My God, the vampires aren't wearing hard hats in a distinctly marked hard hat zone!
Well, as long as Buttcrack Santa remains safe, I'm happy.
Old Buttcrack.
Meanwhile, in daytime...
Huh? Bella seems rather nonchalant about her truck driving itself.
Damn Macaulay Culkin! Iced our steps again!
Also, I drank a 40 for breakfast, so...
Installed a La Cucaracha horn, too.
Beep, 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 beep. Think it was a bear because it sucked all the blood from his corpse, you know.
Well, that explains the rain.
Oh, they count as your birthday and Christmas presents.
Oh, wait, I left a taser on your seat.
This is Forks High School, home of the Spartans!
Please stop calling me girl. I'll kill you.
Wait a second. Where the hell is the armadillo?
The armadillo killed the security guard! Of course, he had to come back on the day she rolled around in manure before school started.
Please leave.
Firm, chiseled jawline. I mean, yeah.
Not osmosis, new girl.
Wash your hands if you win it. The paint is highly toxic.
Gah! The armadillo's back! Get the hell out of here! Yeah, for like a week, things happen, all right?
Went up to Twin Peaks, killed Laura Palmer.
And do you mind if I actually put the slide in?
Oh, sorry, I thought you said poker face, microscopic Lady Gaga's, you know.
I am. I really enjoy how worms are a lot easier to find.
You're asking me about the weather?
We met 3 minutes ago. Should we be discussing whether you're wearing a thong?
My cold, wet things make me stammer and have weird facial tics.
The silver screen cannot contain the heated passion of Twilight.
Just remember, you close the eye that's not up to the lens.
Yeah. This isn't Anna face, it's Anakin!
Don't mix it with sand, it could blow up the building!
All right, only 23 more slides to identify like this.
A title disputed by a crazy old coot who lives in the Great Salt Lake.
Dagnabbit. Does nobody care about winning the Golden Onion? Nobody.
Whoa, slow down. Whoa, you were right.
He keeps asking me when I'm going to turn 18.
She's supposed to look sexy or like she's wearing a rabbit's dentures.
Is metaphase in your pants?
Wait, they won the Golden Onion? Did the rest of the class fall asleep?
Not getting to go to all those great minor league towns. Kinston, North Carolina. Salisbury, Maryland.
Allow me to back you up against a wall and loom over you.
Nah, burst a capillary on the can.
And then again, I blink 90 times a minute, so...
Blood of the mortals, it's, you know.
He combines the composure of George Costanza with the suaveness of David Schwimmer. Girls love it.
Well, I struck out. Looks like another night of knitting wigs for a cat I hope to one day own.
Pretty tough to look badass posing next to a Volvo.
The parking lot. Bustling hub of the Forks social scene.
Just driving 60 miles an hour through the parking lot like I always do.
Pale power.
The drama of the moment is somewhat lessened by her listening to If You Like Pina Coladas on her iPod.
Dun, 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 dun.
And he's off. Faster than a speeding object, which isn't part of a trademarked catchphrase.
Oh my God, the party van got dented, everybody. Oh no. Party van.
I realized that it made no sense that I was driving to school when I should be leaving school, and I panicked.
Well, first a bear attacks a guy in a warehouse roof, and now this.
And why is Rick James standing behind you?
As well as a peripheral character with head trauma who can wait his damn turn.
I canceled my detanning session for this.
Other than excessive blinking.
Apologies impossible through the noise-proof bedsheet.
Copped a cheap feel while he was at it.
Could have been that girly Asian kid that tried to save you. You'd been smushed like a grape.
Yeah, I called the payphone at the garage.
It's stammering, blinking, shaking her head. That psycho.
I mean, hi, Bella.
Look, the baby can't be mine. Sorry, instinctive reaction to that question.
I need a clean urine sample before they'll discharge me.
She blinks at the same rate a hummingbird flaps its wings. Blink, 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 blink.
That was my twin brother, Barney Cullen. I never mentioned Barney. Great guy, Barney.
Something lifted from Smallville, perhaps?
Quoting directly from the abusive guy's handbook there.
Good. Now let me have the golden onion.
The old Corbett family motto there.
Wow.
No, Mr. Belvedere, put down that caulking gun.
What was our math homework?
She's mildly confused about the strange man who threatened her earlier being in her room. Confused.
Ironically, your dad is in the other room fantasizing about Mrs. Achmonic from ALF.
How is that ironic?
Oh, I'm sorry. I meant disgustingly.
I'm pretty sure it was caused by the Baconator I ate for dinner. So, insecure teenage girls, if you eat Baconators, you will dream about Edward Cullen. The more you eat, the sexier you'll dream.
Insurance better still cover that, even though he died of a cerebral hemorrhage last night.
They always look like they're having such fun.
False alarm that she almost got hit by a van?
Ladies.
Please, someone hit him in the head with a volleyball.
Shoot rats at the dump after school?
I will beg if necessary.
Pig's blood.
Every time I dance, God kills a kitten.
You can't go another weekend?
Those exist, right?
Plus, everyone would agree that she's hotter, nicer, and more outgoing than me.
Is biology the only class in this school?
The vampires get their own buzz?
I guess.
Also known as Mountain Dew.
Oh, great! Now you're a mutant!
Oppressive heat and mediocre football.
The head in the bottom left corner is the real star of this scene.
Is that head a boy or a girl?
I stuck a giant head in front of it.
head. Google now!
It's sort of hard to see with the head in front of me.
Ah, the head. The head? So it was a boy?
Yeah, he did. Gnaw on my scraps.
That guy can't get drained of blood fast enough for me.
You hope a vampire gets him?
That's one way.
Your sassy Floridian's remark disgusted me that much.
Well, you've only been at school for a week and a half.
It'd be a lot of paperwork to fill out. It's no fun.
Your lipstick smudged.
Of desiccated animal corpses. We sucked quite a few fawns dry on the way here.
Sit down, have some plaid.
Twice since we divorced.
Just gotta power down 8 more Rainiers. I'll be good. Oh, yeah.
Her curses are even fouler. Laughing while she called me words I had to look up online.
At least he seems that way in Oprah. Little bald for my taste.
Gotta go. Late for my angst class.
So anyway, my Mary Kay lady doesn't carry a white enough foundation for me.
I wonder if he's gonna eat all his tater tots.
That moment can be medically prescribed to induce vomiting.
Mm-hmm.
Ask your doctor.
I'll go if you stop saying that is the phrase that preceded every single date I ever had.
Aha, I'm gay.
And the apple you bounced off your foot is giving me hookworms.
And are you going to eat all your tater tots?
In other words, pretend I'm a Lohan.
Mike's 3% chance of scoring plummets to zero.
Even thought you might be Canadian.
The Noid is.
A hideous, pale, effeminate James Dean mask.
Skip these mashed potatoes with the brown crust on top.
Or that annoying nerd with the girl hair will say La Push again.
Oh. You can spear fish with your spiky hair.
I don't think my brother dad will let me.
Yeah, they're scheduled to dynamite a whale there tomorrow.
Aha, Bodie and Johnny Utah have discovered the joys of Le Push, too.
The Asian nerd really wanted Batgirl-esque nipples on his suit.
He just keeps on listening to his complete Clay Aiken collection.
By the way, can I have one of those juice boxes your mom sent with you?
Ladies?
Bill, those are guys.
Ah, well then, guys who look like ladies?
A casino-free reservation? Is that even legal?
he says a little too forcefully.
His hair's not girlish at all.
You snap one weenie with one wet towel and people get all sensitive.
Yeah, the solid minute of awkward silence kind of highlighted it.
Unlike that guy who stole the secrets to the crystal skull. Damn him. He ruined it. I'm glad he's in jail. Glad.
But what difference does it make? The crystal skull was terrible.
Oh, right. Free the crystal skull guy. Crystal skull guy.
Kibbles and bits.
Well, I'll need to use hand puppets to tell this story.
All right, let's film this Hartford commercial. Oh my God, what have you done?
In Femi get-ups.
Overdressed poachers.
I thought Indian stories were supposed to be good.
Huh, most Seattle area screaming is caused by Candlebox. Rare exception here.
A really dull story. Without a single point of interest, no development, and no denouement, poorly told.
Paul Allen's house isn't all that great.
The entire movie will be shot through boat windshields from here on out. Dang, guess not.
Dark Knight, is that you?
Attack squirrels. I just know it's attack squirrels.
Stop the quick cuts and the wish noises, will ya?
Oh, that's his solution to everything. Start the boat motor. It's what ended his first marriage.
Hey, wondering if I can get a thing of night crawlers and some sucker minnows?
I hope it can become my morning jacket.
It's always the same inane questions.
For the love of God, will you put on a shirt?
Sorry, Mr. Trent Darby.
House, M.D.
Ooh. Hot Google search action. The app that sits on your computer 24 hours a day is now a major motion picture. Only this time, you don't get to participate at all. You just have to sit and watch.
Wait, they didn't install an ad blocker in this film? We're going to be buried in product placement for low-rate home mortgages and wrinkle creams and all those stupid ads for downloadable commentaries.
Kevin?
I love those things!
Angst and low-level trembling. Disaffectedness.
HR Puffin stuff, I mean.
Parenthetically, I possess breasts.
The producers of Twilight would like to remind you that breasts exist.
The Breast Council, in collaboration with Imprint Films, encourages you to have or look at breasts.
How does one tell a good dress from a bad dress?
In short, breasts, Kevin. Breasts.
Breasts.
Have you listened to nothing?
A trying on dresses scene? If your goal was to clear the room of males, there's really no better tool than this, or maybe a good Josh Groban video.
The Boob Council would like to remind you that we are in no way affiliated with the Breast Council.
It's disgusting when we put our breasts on display so that guys look at them and then guys actually look at them.
Even that clear acrylic dress.
Having a hard time finding the right Garfield calendar.
I was worried the movie would water down the book, but all the okay, okay exchanges, thank God, have been kept fully intact. Okay. Okay.
And next time you come in, try not to be so depressed. You scare away my customers. I mean, we specialize in books on the occult, and even we find you depressing. You know, we do have The Wind in the Willows or the Narnia stuff. I could even special order some Norman Vincent Peale.
Damn it. Why do all occult bookstores have to funnel directly into dark, gang-ridden alleys?
Hey, look, boy, she's got a book about Quileute legends. Get her!
Ah, Port Angeles, harassment capital of the Great Northwest.
If this gang seems to lack menace, it's because it's comprised of former extras on Saved by the Bell.
Seriously, where are you going? We formed our gang based on a mutual concern about where you're going.
Seriously, I have scabies, and I would just be mortified if I gave it to you.
You guys, it's the Port Angeles truant officer!
Just toss that fawn carcass in the back.
Chris Angel, mind freak.
But where is she going?
Yes, we must know, please. We have no other reason to cohere as a group. We'll just dissolve, drift into chaos and anomy.
And we may as well dump our six-pack of Rainier down the sewer drain.
Where is she going?
Jeez, guy drives like a vampire.
Mm-hmm.
They were replaying scenes from Daddy Day Camp.
He means he saw a Waffle House and it's killing him not to go back.
Why don't you put your seatbelt on?
No, why don't you put your seatbelt on?
We ate your food, too.
I'm sorry, I just turned into Christopher Walken for a moment.
It's kind of a vampire thing, but, no.
Awkward small talk, the motion picture.
Something off the dollar menu only, though.
Especially if you get me another rib platter to go.
Something? Why, Arby's specialty is something.
And
your whole raw fawn should be out any second, sir.
Food ruins my lipstick.
Her twitchy angst level makes Annie Hall look like Joan of Arc.
Oh, he eats all right.
I only eat eucalyptus leaves. You see, I'm a koala bear.
Oh, stuff it, Karnak. I'm serious.
Pie.
Fine, I'll go get my own damn extra gravy.
That's a kind word for it.
Gassy.
Which is why I secretly videotape all your movements.
By lowlifes, I assume he means old ladies who only get out their checkbooks once the clerk has told them what the total is.
Clearly.
Yeah, and most of them are plotting to kill Ziggy cartoonist Tom Wilson.
Bastards.
And the guy in the corner wearing the tinfoil hat.
It works. Cat sex, actually.
No, no, you can read it. There just isn't anything.
It's your personality. It's possible it's just too peppy.
Come on, what is wrong with you?
Whoa, mood swing. Holy cats.
What is it?
A wang.
Or to lift a lady's beginner kettlebell. Can you help me?
Line?
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 My legs are now medium rare.
What and stuff?
How cold is it?
Line.
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 I do not know what is going on.
Or does your special diet prevent you from doing this one simple thing?
I recognize this Calvin peeing on a Toyota static decal.
And what I mean is, why are we the same age?
We bought him some oars, he rode in, and everything's fine.
We're questioning Dr. Teeth right now.
Maybe you can stop him from extracting his friend's gold fillings.
Yeah, we can...
Yeah, right.
And then...
Okay, no, that's... great, no.
Maybe I can...
What if...
Well, all if right, it, yeah,
is it,
that's cool.
No, really, it's about...
How come all my friends have to get eaten by animals?
Line?
About your village people mustache, I mean.
I heard om gum om 30 years, you guys?
Yep, om gum om 30 years.
Line?
I think it's mine, but I forgot again.
And by that, he means his lost tin of mustache wax.
It's a chunk from an old busted tire pump. We also promised to carry a pen cap and four rusty bolts.
To the only antidote to the pain caused by my dear friend's horrible death, an all-new full-hour episode of Gary Unmarried.
You feel like saying a line yet?
Nah, if I think of anything, I'll let you know.
Watch it, shockingly maimed dead guy coming through.
Just leading to a flashback of when the lunchroom served those horrible mock turkey legs.
Can your heart stand another Google search?
Meanwhile, that Port Angeles gang has shown up outside her window. So, is this where you were going? Because you made a couple of stops before here, yet this seems more destination-y, and we're a little up in the air and hoping you could settle it.
Quickly go to one of the many I Hate Twilight forums and call someone Hitler.
The Ancient Legend of Kirstie Alley.
This This section was compiled by the Bangles, so it's loaded with information about how to walk like them.
Bill Maher!
Walmart on Black Friday!
Who wants the first slice of birthday, man?
Gah! Oh, I thought it said speed 2. I'm okay now.
Now I assume it will zoom into the words very delicate and arms like pipe cleaners.
Make terrible lab partners. Look down and mumble a lot.
Give the impression they wouldn't know how to throw a football.
Their counting of items is often followed by thunder and lightning.
Endorse chocolate marshmallow breakfast cereals.
Line?
All right.
She's just trying to remember where she dropped her favorite gel pen.
Looks like the love child of Matthew Perry and powder.
Ms. Swan, stop that staring and walking in slow motion and get to class right now, young lady.
Well, someone's in a good mood today.
And she lifts his wallet. Sucker.
They are going to skip the living hell out of third hour study hall.
Well, now's as good a time as any to go looking for Bigfoot.
Oh, good staring terrain. Nice place for trembly, half-mumbled sentences. I like it.
Is she talking to me?
I thought it was me. Your pants are snarky and hostile.
Like 10:42 p.m.
It's almost like you're British.
So I expect puberty to hit any time now.
Well, I'm still a fan of the Backstreet Boys. Does that give you a hint?
It's not what you think. I'm just trying to avoid the draft.
You haven't had one since 73.
Don't!
Cameraman is being chased by a badger. Okay, you're a thoroughgoing douche.
No, you're not doing it right.
A tool?
No!
No.
Close. I'm a metropire.
Seriously, I don't know what emotion you're going for, because you always just look nauseous.
Line?
Oh, not you now. Just stop it. Stop it now.
And the answer is my dad usually isn't around for dinner, so mostly we end up eating pizza rolls.
You're going to watch me eat a pizza roll right now, and you'll see just how terrifying I can be.
Okay, I'll stop now.
Ow, I took a lot of June bugs to the forehead.
This is why we don't show ourselves in sunlight.
Yeah, because they wouldn't pick that up from the fact that you people date your own family.
An off-brand version of Johnny Depp wearing body glitter.
Yes, but at a fraction of the cost. Order now, and you'll also get this two-piece Snuggie set.
You're beautiful. Ugh. You're beautiful. Ugh. Again, she looks like someone who just ate a whole sausage roll and downed a liter of generic root beer.
We're going on our When You Were Young tour tomorrow.
I'm actually a stick insect.
Predator?
Get to the chopper!
Yeah, about that. Whew.
Roadrunner, the coyote's after you. Roadrunner, if he catches you, you're through.
Actually, I think Paul from the Wonder Years could fight you off.
And so is the new BK Stacker from Burger King.
But they were from Port Angeles, so...
If it's not a barrier to getting a job at the post office, why should I let it stand in my way?
When you were going 45 in the passing lane.
Except for Steve Bartman. I was so mad. I think I was the first one to have his Bartman Must Die t-shirts up on Cafe Press after the game.
We were getting carried away with the big gulps.
Oh, that. I put on some Buckler this morning. You like it?
Charming, and you're like the aerosol nonstick oil I spray into a dirty paper bag and inhale.
Ah, love. When we met, oh, like I don't now.
My bladder, I mean. It's unrelated. I'm sorry.
She once threw herself into the hyena exhibit at the zoo because she trusted them, too.
Well, it involves unwelcome boners.
Because you pinned me up against a large rock scorpion.
I briefly dated the ShamWow guy, so, you know.
It wasn't very long. You just didn't know that.
So, if I just say I'm a vampire, I wonder if I can pull off that groping thing you just did.
You forgot thin, womany, unappealing, whiny, and punchable.
Mm-hmm.
Ah, the cameraman fainted from blood loss after that badger attack.
And now it's Badger Cam.
And then Jessie said she wasn't going to go to High School Musical 3 because Sarah's mom wouldn't drive us, but I had already bought tickets, so I was like, gah!
No interest in his recently confessed murders? Just didn't raise any alarm bells, huh?
Oh, come on, Mike. You don't bother with a trifle like how many lives he snuffed out when you meet someone with eyebrows like that?
And he has his own car. Hell, a high school girl like her would date Khalid Shaikh Muhammad if he had his own car.
They can't even work up the energy for furtive mumbling anymore. They're just going to lie there for the rest of the movie.
Ah, my alien masters are here for me. Oh, forgot to tell you about that part, didn't I?
So, if you girls listening out there, just so it's clear, this is not, I repeat, not a dream date for any actual living male. You're more likely to find a guy who would enjoy spending the afternoon trying on hats.
You okay just hanging here being undead all afternoon?
Mo, Larry, Curly, wait, four.
Or a member of The Cure.
We are not talking about Phil Spector, right? I just want to be clear.
I don't think so.
hopelessly devoted, as the poet might say.
That poet being Olivia Newton-John.
Right.
Well, it beat out death to the spotted owl.
Ah, naturally, I thought you meant ward bond.
I'm so totally twittering about this right now. I'm like totally twittering. OMG, OMG, you guys. It's Edward and Belle. I'd say more, but I only have 140 characters. I just totally twittered that. Oh, OMG.
They're not staring, they're sniffing. Do vampires ever shower?
I owe him $6.
Man, look at all the rules they're breaking. Wow.
To like Coldplay?
Yes.
The tan bastard. Or to a fatty.
You mean cool and detached?
He let the rest of the flu ward perish. He must have liked the cut of my jib.
Like watching Tommy Wiseau act.
No, he bites.
Smuckers, jams, and jellies.
Frenzy meaning Tupperware party.
I'm gonna, like, puke. Ow.
Yeah, he made me pinky swear that I wouldn't.
Killing is really hard on your clothes.
Except when I play ping pong, then whoa.
Ah, so your family's confused or stupid.
Blech. Oh, dear. Not like Snickers. Snickers.
Man, your blood would rock. It'd be like this huge Napa Cabernet. It'd be so choice. Oh, sorry.
There are others out there.
We think it might be goat suckers from Juarez.
I'm thinking the answer to you.
Just 2 minutes in, though.
Oh, and stay clear of Uncle Manhattan. He can blow you to pieces with his mind.
Whoopee.
You like hanging upside down?
I was thinking of renting one.
He's walking again.
I'm a chick. It's all I got.
I just love the taste of grandparents.
Just gonna head out and grab the rest of the plot.
Morning, Hellbeast.
Morning, minor character.
Well, I think my truck is clean enough now.
Would it be rude to nickname this guy Chief Ironside?
Probably.
Well, that truck and I were lovers.
You poor bastards.
For sheezy, my kneesies.
You He can scoop the breading off the bottom of the bag.
I figured vegetable or mineral.
Hey, my boyfriend only drinks tofu blood or something.
Seems like every small town in the Pacific Northwest has either survivalist militia or vampires.
Ooh, I hope they don't team up.
Acres around him and he blocks the drive.
Ooh, he could make a fortune as a parking valet.
Man.
Bob, I'm home. You got any blood pockets in the fridge?
It was designed by Mies van der Rohe.
Like a Pillsbury crescent roll.
Burns and Allen, Nichols and May, and now Vampire Dude and Emo Chick, ladies and gentlemen.
Unless we're, you know, playing hide and seek.
Tonight they're serving Neil Scalapini, Bruce Liver Pate, medallions of Keith, Pam Chowder, hearts of Bob salad with thousand eyeball dressing.
Okay, Bill, thank you.
Sounds good.
I'm sorry.
Rancid elephant meat brined in gasoline.
Well, she's lucky. My in-laws are German.
Oh.
Mario Batali, huh?
It's another episode of According to Vlad on the CW.
It's like you guys, I'm like, wow, you know? Guys?
We could become uncool.
We're Unitarians.
Her polite way of saying, eat me.
Nicely done.
Oh, no, no, an elf!
I'm Harpo.
I'm Harpo!
But Harpo wants to eat your marrow.
It's got a vampire chubby.
Now give him a chew toy.
Shorthand for, you're dead, I'm gonna suck you dry.
Oh, it's fun being eternally damned.
I'm Harpo.
Go to my room. We can mumble and pose some more, you know. Yeah, MBA blood is delicious.
Huh?
So that's how Dick Clark did it for so long.
Clever bastard.
Do you like Legos? Because I got tons of Legos. I got Lego Star Wars and the Power Miners, and I got like a bajillion Bionicles, too.
I know you're wondering about all the Danielle Steele books. It's part of the Vampire Code. You see, she's our queen and high prophet, Danielle be praised.
Have a personality.
But wait, he has a daybed. They're intentionally trying to confuse us.
playing with our heads.
Should I tell her about the TP stuck to her pants?
Kids Bop 9, pinnacle of the Kids Bop series, I think.
I know, it's kind of hard-edged.
Yeah, I got John Mayer's version. It's cool. Guggenheim Grotto does it too, I think.
Okay, good. We just watch them hanging around all afternoon, mooning at each other.
Maybe later they'll drink goji berry pomegranate green tea and post some Serenity fanfic.
Who knows? He might even break out his guitar and sing Hallelujah to her.
Yeah, yeah, and then we can all slit our wrists.
You guys mind if I slit my wrists right now, get ahead of the curve?
Oh, any old time, Mike.
Surprised you haven't done it by now.
You'll get no argument from us.
Here, let me get a little paler for you.
When 7-year-olds flirt.
I know you are, but what am I?
Well, you really shouldn't have said that.
Little something I borrowed from a kung fu film.
That's a reference to her already legendary poo-flinging exploits.
Can I call my lawyer first?
Yes, being a vampire gives you the awesome power to win the Paul Bunyan Day's lumberjack competition.
Yeah, it was fun until they slammed into that eagle's nest.
I still can't dance.
Oh, pretty good view of Hogwarts.
Wee, this is fun. Oh, I love you, Edward, and I... Whoops. Oh, God!
Later, in the sanctuary of his room, Edward and Bella would spend the night tearing wads of bark and pine tar out of their hair and plucking the many dozens of deeply embedded deer ticks off each other.
Their treetop canoodling was soured only by the community of filthy hippies living in the next tree over to prevent it from being cut down.
This is a ballad that I wrote just for you. I want to jump into your throat and watch you bleed out on the floor. Then I'll bathe myself in your life essence as you die. Tear your heart out of your chest and crack the bones and suck the marrow out. Slice into your brain for sandwiches and maybe have an omelet made of...
Okay, thank you, Kevin. Very nice.
I have more.
Yeah, I'm sure you do. Oh, what a shame. The song's over.
Hillbilly vampires, the worst kind.
Hang on there, fellas. Wanna lift my leg on the evidence here.
This woman has corns.
Well, almost. She's from Idaho.
Take off your rainbow shades!
It endorkens me. Even more.
No, wait, I was thinking of Hurley from Lost.
Ladies and gentlemen, Twilight series author Filth E. Rich.
How would I get my vitamin beef?
The boys.
I found a fishing lure stuck in a tree.
Move along, nothing to see here, basically.
boys. He shouldn't be telling these children such things.
No, that's an escapee from a Judd Apatow movie.
Binge drink or something.
He did not suck my blood. I'm sorry, what?
Well, I'm seeing a new fella.
Put out so the boys will like you.
I'd like to meet this dad of yours and... Oh, you mean... I gotcha.
He can fit a whole can of snuff in his cheek now.
There's so many trailer parks.
Forks are growing on you.
Hi, can I clean your windows?
Are you using garlic?
The chimney. I'm also part Santa Claus.
Really ramped up my stocking.
Extra creepy.
And did you know you snore like Shemp Howard?
It involves a clown nose. I'm going to put this nose on you now.
Hey, Dracula, I'm going to lunch. You call me when you get some, okay?
Oh, good God, a peewee football team takes less time to score.
You know, you could have mentioned the forked tongue. Blech.
This just doesn't feel right without some Jack Johnson or Iron and Wine droning in the background.
Why does it sound so leathery? Are they rubbing baseball gloves?
That is one powerful boner.
I mean, you're really ticklish.
I'm super incredicelibate.
He just realized that she was the girl who almost did that Into the Wild guy.
You mean go nuts lose control or drain her arteries lose control? There's a difference.
Okay, just let me go fix my makeup, my hair, maybe put on a cooler shirt.
We sat up all night and just talked is an admission that no straight man would ever make.
Well, if you say we sat up all night and then boom, then everyone would know nothing happened, but you'd save face.
And that is our advice for young men everywhere.
There you go.
Wait a minute. No, don't do that. My cat does that and I hate it. And ugh, man, your hair smells like artificial fruit flavor. What do you use, Suave? I'm gonna die here. Get the hell off me.
Ah, shotguns and beer.
Hang on, I'm not quite drunk enough.
He's a pepper, I'm a pepper.
I thought you didn't like any of the boys in town.
Well, he actually doesn't live at all.
He brought a notary public vampire with him.
I'm wearing my boyfriend meeting toupee. What more do you want?
Maybe just a light kneecapping.
Majoring in hematology.
What are you, deaf, old man?
I mean, yes, sir.
She'll probably come home alive. Ish.
And I got a nice clean drop piece. You could hide it in your little elf boot there. I'm just saying.
It's Tug McGraw, vampire. Pete Rose, huge vampire.
Hey, don't go chasing those, you guys.
We won't, hey, don't. Bill. Okay. Promise.
Don't.
We stand warm.
Don't chase him.
Let me just flop you around like a puppet here.
Ah, yes. Baseball, vampires, and the music of Perry Farrell. Three American icons.
Shouldn't Marilyn Manson sing the national anthem?
The pitch is high and girly.
I don't. They're in Washington State, right? People fire off guns there more often than they sneeze.
His Tommy John surgery was very successful.
Careful, she's the Roberto Alomar of vampires.
Why don't you just put a stake through my heart and lop off my head?
All right, Dad's up. Everybody move in.
Let's see him hit my puffball.
Look out, it's Vampire Jeffrey Meyer.
Oh, I love you, character we don't know.
Starting to think that maybe Alex Rodriguez copped to steroids to cover up his vampirism.
Sure, but try going up against some real ballplayers like Jet Li or Chow Yun-Fat.
Referring, of course, to his cherry red butt cheeks.
I smell many donuts.
Vampires are powerless against mini donuts.
All that sugar, all that cinnamon.
My God, it's Fairport Convention. They're going to kill us with Celtic rock.
Ah!
Well, they have home plate covered.
We have to charge the mound like Richie Sexson.
Three words, honey. Mitchum, roll on.
Wow, get that feller a bra.
Ah, she'll be hearing that for many years to come.
Oh, sure. Sure, they're strutting and pouting, but are they putting it out?
Stop looking at my moobs.
Ow.
Lead singer.
I make my own clothes.
I used to be Sean Mullins.
We're doing the Fantastics at the dinner theater.
We'll send you some steaks.
Come on over. We'll play Scattergories.
So why the sarcasm, honey? Really?
I can bunt 300 feet.
Bat first, get it?
Ah, pale trash-talking baseball vampires. Love them.
Try not to look so human.
He's wordlessly challenging him to a shirt-off.
Someone's eating Mentos.
It's the Twilight fans and the anti-fans squaring off.
Or we can squat here all afternoon, whatever.
Wow. Thunderstorm kind of fizzled out anyway.
Everything's gonna be all right. Rock-a-bye. Rock-a-bye.
The traditional vampiric salutation.
Thank God for all-day lip gloss.
You know where the after party is? Don't tell the evil vampires, though.
She narrowly missed being recruited by the Kansas City Royals.
Turned into Jerry Lewis there for a moment.
Oh, honey, just think of this as a goofy sort of Pretty in Pink thing. You're Molly Ringwald and I'm Andrew McCarthy, and we're being chased by an evil, bloodthirsty Super John Cryer.
Super Ducky.
Super Ducky.
You know, the usual girlfriend stuff.
Thomas Wolfe says so.
But then he'll be in heaven with butt-crack Santa.
My dad has my iPhone! Quick, let's look longingly at each other for a few more hours.
Stan Marsh's dad was modeled after this guy, you know.
You go back and kiss that boy goodnight, young lady.
I just gotta get out of here.
I mean, you don't even have Wi-Fi.
Wow, new pasty blank boyfriend already?
Oh, same kid.
Uh-oh.
She could with a crowbar, even if she can't swing it that hard. I mean, that would hurt him.
Munching on some voles.
In the sense that boredom can be painful, yeah.
Insult the Jonas Brothers, or...
I like him, Dad. Like!
I find the constant rain here far too cheerful.
They discovered a new Allman Brother.
And by it, I mean the pile of newspapers in the basement. I rented your room.
And listen to Michael Savage.
How about, we'll get a monkey, okay? Oh, but maybe two monkeys. Look, how many monkeys will it take?
I just relearned how to be oppressively sarcastic to my child.
I want to follow minimum wage earning meatheads to the sweaty armpits of the U.S.
I think it's against the law to drive a truck like that without a mangy old coonhound in the back.
I gotta report her for coonhound violation.
Would you like fries with that?
Big deal. I did that driver switch move in college while playing hacky sack.
His mustache got all droopy.
Aww.
Though taunting her dad for his impotence was a little inappropriate, I think.
Ah, we hit a turtle!
Emmett the Dude Vampire.
Oh, it's B. Toklas. Oh, she's a vampire, all right, and longtime companion of Gertrude Frankenstein.
Haha, we are having generic teenage fun.
Wow, suddenly being hunted by a bloodthirsty undead guy seems great by comparison.
And to start the Black Eyed Peas.
Howie Mandel, I assume he means.
She will kick your ass in Chutes and Ladders.
We just need a hydrogen bomb.
Remember, he did direct Titanic.
Oh, well, that James.
Somehow he knows that.
Yeah, like you had no idea I think you're a wanker.
With love and squalor. Quoting Carlo Gambino. Quoting Charles Manson.
But look at these clothes. She shops at Kmart. Blah.
Vampires are fun.
She loves him based on him not killing her. That's healthy.
Well, nothing's happened so far.
For some reason.
Well, I look forward to many, many more scenes of her being anxious and trembly. I also look forward to many, many more kicks in the groin.
Grand Forks got demoted.
It's just too much trouble to think about it.
These guys have a ton of collisions with snowmobiles in the winter.
Ah, the Giving Tree finally gets some.
Ah, family. Sexy family.
Ooh, big change of scenery. Guess the ghost of John Ford has taken over the movie from here.
Vampires will now be played by horses.
Yeah, squint your eyes and show your teeth all vampire-like much as you want, but the ponytail still makes you look douchey. Douchey.
Practice my Lamaze quick here.
This change in locations wasn't inspired by plot. The director just had seasonal affective disorder.
We'll continue with the story in a moment, folks, after the movie finishes checking into its hotel. Have a nice day.
Something involving a really douchey ponytail.
Whoa! Two dogs doing it!
At Albuquerque, accompanied by a cartoon rabbit.
Brad Pitt's bedroom?
How convenient.
It's like having a mental CB radio, huh?
You're still here?
Prove it. Dance around like a leathery retiree.
He's the Indian guy in the wheelchair, right?
Except be less bland. That's where I draw the line, Missy.
And yet, even in doing that, you weren't bland enough.
It's impossible, man. Be fair, Mike.
That's true.
Twilight, brought to you by Nokia.
Why did I name you that? Sounds dumb. Yeah, just dumb.
Ugh, it's Bill O'Reilly.
Jeez, I feel cheated of the scene in front of the computer where she said, "I'm in."
The Indian guy in the wheelchair, right?
Yes. She has a highly contagious rash.
But you're gonna have to get away from your friends.
At Deb's House of Ponytails, I'm going in for the yearly checkup.
Planning that room service won't bring them people for dinner.
And their acute vampire senses missed her casually strolling out the front door.
The Marriott, for business, vacation, or fleeing undead predators. Stay at the Marriott.
Sadly, this movie has made me think of her death.
Also, eating too many fluffernutters seems like a good way to go.
Have a nice day, young lady, and remember, someday a real rain will come and wash all this scum off the streets. Bye-bye.
Hey, wait a minute. He's a total bore. This whole arrangement sucks.
Got my spray bottle of I can't believe it's not butter. Good, in case I run into some corn on the cob.
A Phoenix dance studio. Yep, first thing I'd say if I saw that.
Hello? Very unthreatening looking ponytail guy who everyone is supposed to believe is threatening? Are you here?
May as well practice my arabesques while I'm waiting.
A big studio. Did the Russian army do ballet there?
Whoa! Two dogs doing it!
It's funny, because I suck too.
The douchebag from Shanghai.
May the ghost of Orson Welles haunt them, bitterly drunk on Parmesan wine.
The part where I slightly turn my douchey head in the mirror three times? The best.
Oh man, you totally smell like olive loaf.
Okay, from here on, I won't accept vampires lacking proper Transylvanian accents.
We're gonna trade ponytail maintenance tips.
Smile and say, "My blood tastes really, really delicious."
His vampirism is a complete coincidence, unrelated to this current predicament.
Least threatening movie villain since that floating plastic bag in American Beauty.
That plastic bag wasn't even supposed to be the villain.
Yes, vampires keep themselves harnessed to the ceiling at all times in case a production of Peter Pan breaks out.
Should have sprayed him with old lady perfume. That stuff will melt your eyes.
Well, the sick thing is he's gotten numerous NEA grants for his pre-murder videos.
Figures, being a guy without a ponytail.
Hi.
What kind of sub-WWE move was that? Do we need to get a turnbuckle and some folding chairs in here?
Answer, yes we do, if only to give this movie a modicum of dignity.
Hey, someone needs PetSmart Obedience School.
I hate swiftness!
Well, at least give you a very severe wedgie.
But this has nothing at all to do with you! Again, that had nothing to do with you, honey. Unrelated to you, honey, in any way!
So, vampire fighting technique is 100% about throwing each other into glass.
Crunchalicious!
Foul, that's wood, not glass! What are you, werewolves?
Infected already? Ponytail boy must never brush his teeth.
Well, he does, only with possums.
Haha! I'm secretly a Romanian girl gymnast!
He's gonna kill the already dead guy. Wait, how does this work?
Hell, I can't even think about it. They've been so slipshod on the glass breakage that I don't even think these clowns are vampires anyway. Just two emo boys having a little tiff.
Is there a production of Peter Pan here? Because we're ready.
A noble, proud sucker of the blood of other living creatures.
To make her hammy acting look good by comparison.
Yep, someone's gonna get a shaved head and a magic-markered weenus.
Yeah, I went out with a girl like that once. She gave me such mixed signals. Yeah, jumped me, broke my neck, and then the fire. Actress, of course.
Yeah.
She's reciting her junior high poetry. Make it stop!
She's a tad young for menopause.
I'd say not. Option? What is this, a car dealership?
That's the group that employs George H.W. Bush!
Should have done that for the Spider-Man 3 script.
Your knee is on my hand!
That knee on your hand, I mean, because it's mine and I can do that. Eventually.
Tastes like teenage chicken.
Just a typical night at Jack Nicholson's house, circa 1975.
Completely fireproof ballet studio. Very common in Phoenix.
You're gonna turn her into Keith Richards!
Just one more sip.
Burning ponytail must smell awful.
Alright, I'm having another acid flashback, right?
No, that's the movie.
So, you guys also see Jim Neighbors riding a killer whale in space?
Well, no.
Wish I did, though. It sounds great.
Hey, folks, remember that movie you've been watching? Yeah, this one? Well, here's some clips from it.
Enjoy. Death is also a cheesy Eagles song, too, apparently.
She's a renowned thanatologist / Ally and AJ fan.
Where the hell did you put the TV remotes? Come on, I want to watch Ellen, damn it!
Where's that dreamy boy with the ponytail?
All right, that's quite enough.
Just let me finish one last one. Thank you.
Whoa, back off, Mom. We're not blind.
Mr. Bean's daughter, Bella Bean.
It was awesome, honey.
Hey.
Remember that time I fell off the Empire State Building just by walking down the street from it? I'm so clumsy.
So worried, he almost decided to become a real character in this movie.
And become old and or Cuban.
And we found the cutest little house.
It's the only place in America where my truck doesn't stand out.
On the way to Florida.
Duh.
I acted like a total ass to him. I acted like you, that is.
Okay, honey, I'm gonna go give the DNR order now. Bye-bye.
Sheesh, who do you have to pay to get a bedpan emptying in this joint?
We sold his remains to Hardee's. Told him it was a horse.
To join the vampire circus.
I slipped the admitting nurse at 20.
Stop acting, I assume she means.
He was wildly successful at it.
True.
You know, personally, I don't think you could ever prove he started acting, guys.
True.
Wow, she jumped ahead in the script, like 8 pages.
Coached by Shia LaBeouf for this scene.
Oh, she swallowed a gnat.
Look, honey, I can handle regular vampires, but clingy emotional vampires? Ugh.
She makes Sylvia Plath seem like Cyndi Lauper.
A coffin for all eternity? Aren't you kind of overdue for that appointment, guy?
Wow, I'm weakening, guys. I mean, suddenly I feel very invested in their love. It's my love, too. Them succeeding despite all odds means I succeed despite all odds. Look, beautiful trees, as beautiful as the love of Edward and Bella and me and their beauty. Ow! You hit me with a phone book.
Yep.
So, you're as gay as all hell, aren't you?
Well, hey, the girl from the glass menagerie is staying with him.
Blue roses.
World's least stealthy cat burglar.
What, is this too dressy for the diner?
In fact, you need a matching one. Here, let me quick break your other leg.
Crunch!
Oh, Dad, you're so impotent, just like Mom says.
In case you want to add a little heat to the chicken a la king they're serving for prom dinner, man, that stuff can be bland.
In a future librarian spinster kind of way.
Home by midnight and not undead, young lady.
He didn't even wear his tux and huge bat-like vampire cape for the occasion.
Doing some freelance forestry, I see.
Yeah, but she's a brown bear, kind of shy about that.
Dad's regional manager for Amway.
Your boyfriend, General Custer. Our people aren't very fond of him.
along with Sting.
And then I'm going to get like 100 restraining orders against him.
Sexual tension between these guys is off the charts.
Yeah, would you just be white? I mean, it's 2009.
His prediction? Probably pain.
Not even those Funtex Avery wolves who hoot and holler and make their eyeballs pop out of the sockets.
You know, I honestly think she doesn't know how to smile. It's doomed to come off as another grotesque rictus of teen angst.
Oops, he almost stepped in a dead gopher there.
Staying alive, staying alive, staying... Oh, sorry, Edward, that was really insensitive of me.
Oh, and FYI, part of that rite of passage includes the drunk puke in the ladies' room, where you implore other girls to hold your hair. So, let's start getting them slow gin fizzes into you.
Yeah, my date is incredibly gay, I know.
I guess he's the only black kid in school. He has to be extra super duper quote unquote black. It's awesome responsibility.
Yeah,
I don't know who you are, but hi.
Oh, I assumed he meant go, as in I have to go.
You might be right. Could just be an extra fancy al fresco restroom.
My leg being shattered in 12 places, maybe?
Oop, another dead gopher. Better start watching where you step. There's a ton of them all over the floor.
Well, it is the prom's theme.
Yep.
In a great-grandma at a wedding kind of way.
Oh, I hear some of you out there, folks. You're saying, but the story's over. It was barely a story, but it's indisputably over. Yes, yes, I agree. But if you've watched this long, it's assumed that you're a teenage girl who really wants to meet a sweet vampire boy herself. And this is just more marshmallow on your sundae. So take out your spoon and gobble it up. Sweet marshmallowy goodness.
Tall and bland with eraser head hair.
How could I go on without your quick smile, your easy laugh, your way of brightening up every day?
Little shout out to all the Suicide Watch kids in the audience.
It's the way it's supposed to be.
Oh, well, she only meant that you'd eventually become as boring as me if we stayed together. I have that effect on people.
I dream about becoming a monster of rock, personally.
It's almost as exciting as the dream where I organize my sock drawer forever.
Whoa, cameraman teleported.
My God, the cameraman is a jumper.
This might be construed as a metaphor for sex and virginity, but to me it's a metaphor for a song by Meatloaf.
Or maybe just Meatloaf the entree. When cooked right, it's very tempting.
No doubt.
Hell no! I want to skitter up trees and punch the crap out of cars and throw other vampires through glass!
But later I'll be needing some of that happiness in the form of cash.
Well, I have to admit, my prom didn't have anything like the romance of this one.
But where did they hold yours?
In a smaller place, much, much smaller. And it wasn't so much they as me. Well, and the G.I. Joes. Look, I tried to make it romantic, but when the microwave cheese whiz spilled, it kind of killed the mood.
Okay.
Huh?
Except the French, if they are in earshot.
I want tennis shoes that convert into fly fishing waders. Oh, and this, you know, vampire kid. But if I had to choose, it would definitely be tennis shoes / fly fishing waders.
Ah, it's, Twilight author Stephanie Meyer. She is not happy with this production. Oh, dear Lord, she's got a sniper rifle!
Ah, yes, her, this lovely woman who was in exactly 5 seconds of this movie. She'll be playing us out of here today.
Wow, she just quadrupled her screen time in Twilight.
And as this young woman tries in vain to beckon us into a sequel and the usual suspects are rounded up in the credits, we at RiffTrax.com,
the second most dangerous predators on the planet,
a third if you count internet Nigerian princes,
well, we say goodbye. All right, goodbye.
RiffTrax, some movies have it coming. This has been a RiffTrax presentation. RiffTrax, copyright by RiffTrax and Legend Films. All rights reserved. Unauthorized use or duplication is prohibited.